So it looks like I may need to make this roof a little higher, otherwise when I jump out of the saddle... Oh, no, I thought I was going to jump out of the saddle and end up on the roof, but I've literally ended up inside the dinosaur. Ha, okay. Oh, what is going on, guys? Unite the Clans here, back in y'all lives with another episode of Ark Survival Evolved, and we are at our place out on Craig's Island at sunrise. Today, what I think we're gonna do is build a barn or a shed for this guy, this Ankylo. This is Francis. He actually belongs to another YouTuber on the server, but they've been away and Francis was short on food and I haven't seen the guy on in a long time, so I brought her over here just so I could keep her fed. And I think as long as I have her, I'm gonna use her to collect stone for me. And I have big plans for this place. I would fly around and give you a good tour of the island. Here, let's hop on Forest King here. I would give you a good tour of the island, but I have in the last couple days killed both my pteranodons. Are you a high-level raptor? Are you coming at me yet? No, you're not coming at me yet. Where are you? Come on. Come on. What is he? Oh, here. Level 44. Okay, I think we can take that down. So both my stupid pteranodons are dead. Bad things happening. One of them... Oh, I can't remember. Just bad things have happened. Kill this raptor real quick. Oh, I'm not killing him. There you go. Get killed. Get wrecked. There you go. Cool. So we're going to take Forest King around to the base. I'm going to grab some of the basic materials we need. And we're going to start building a little mini barn. Now the idea is to have a safe place for all my dinosaurs. I had briefly considered building one mega barn to keep everything in, but when I started planning it out, the scale seemed way too huge. And I'm cool with taking my time to get a cool looking barn built. You know what? I'm thinking we might have a few small ones littered around the island. Like, I already have this build here, and that's where I was keeping my flyers. You can see the Argentavis up there. Maybe we'll come back for her. I'll just park Forest King by my cabin, and we'll go from there. And, I'm going to have to... It'll be an order of business for me coming up soon to tame a new pteranodon. I really like them. They're one of my favorite dinosaurs in the game. Definitely my favorite flyer. And I'm actually looking for a high-level parasaur as well. You'll see why. There's a group of parasaurs there with this thing is terrible for spotting because of those giant horns. I won't even bother. If you're high-level, I'll worry about you later. My cabin just up here. Sorry, I'm super distracted, guys. But yes, we're going to build a barn. Oh, hello. Mine are definitely dead. And that's not just sitting there, is it? Hi. I'm squishy. Does that thing already have a saddle on it? Oh my gosh. This server is so great. Somebody just gave me a new terrain. Here, let's first person mode. Pull that up. Zoom in. Call him over. Now... Gil, who's the guy that gave me 0-2, the best 0 ever, the highest level 0 ever, Gil gave me that. Oh, I'm a little too encumbered for this beast. Here, put you down. This, though, when Lady M gave me 0-1, she suggested naming it Squishy. So, if I have to guess, that's Lady M giving me this beast. Whoever it is, thank you so much. I did the intro to this episode saying... how much I need to track down a brand new dino, a brand new flyer for myself. And here one is waiting. So we'll take him around. We'll do a little tour. I really just want to unload. This is normally where I keep my tools, but inventory is too heavy to fly around on that new bird, obviously. So let's empty it as much as we can. So let's grab Squishy. How sick is that? Maybe he's not I'm Squishy. Maybe that's I am for Iron Mine. Either way, Oh, we got some speed now. Oh, that is sweet. Okay, well, let's fly up. I didn't think we were going to be able to get this aerial view. Let's get an aerial view of the island. So, two main peaks. Now, we've been building on this stretch of grassland that you see cuts through the forest beneath me. That's the first area I'm going to build up. You can see a work-in-progress blacksmith shop. We'll spend an episode doing this thing up. But that's my work-in-progress blacksmith shop right here. And so then, yeah, there's a couple of these pathways that cut through the island. And there's two peaks. The first of the two peaks is up here. Now, I haven't yet figured out what to build here. Maybe a giant church, because I do want this island to be a village. Also, maybe a PvP coliseum, because after we built the racetrack, I want more giant group projects that inspire competition and that sort of thing. And then there's another cut through of the forest. This one is all beach. And I think what I'm going to do is go through here, lay down a bunch of small thatch foundations, and invite server members to come and build here. Because if I want to get a village built by the end of this season on the Iron Mine server, I'm going to have to get my butt in gear. But the project for today is a barn. And that is a barn for Frances, and she is the best method I have right now for collecting rock. And for this peak, the one that surrounds this giant rock here, I don't think I should build... I think a castle is what is required. Just look at those sheer cliffs. Imagine a castle that wraps all the way around the outside of this, how cool that would be. So that's what I have roughly in mind. And if we're going to be doing that, and we're going to be doing stone buildings in general... we need a quick, efficient way to gather it. So I have brought Frances over here. We're going to build her a barn. And to work in conjunction with her, I've been taming up some parasaurs as pack animals. You going to stay here, Squishy? Yes, you are. And you can see him right here. That's Leo in the blue. There's Mikey in the orange. And there's Raph in the red. I'm going to do some Teenage Mutant Ninja parasaurs. Anyway, so those are my pack animals. So if we have a barn over here... and old Frances can go down this slope and collect some of these rocks that are at the bottom of these cliffs, and then we have beasts to haul them back up. That's what I have in mind. So I want to do a build, but I do not want to do it too close to these rocks that might cause them to despawn. So I think what I'm going to do is chop down these trees. And actually, if you haven't seen a sickle, I've never shown you one. It is so sick. Fiber only, no berries. Game changer. I'm going to cut out all these plants. And then I'm going to chop down these trees, and then I'm going to come back with you guys, and we are going to get to work. We are going to get to work on building a barn for Frances, and ideally I'd like it to have sort of a loading bay type area where I can empty gear from Frances into some storage containers, and then I can ride my Teenage Mutant Ninja Parasaurs up on the outside, access those storage containers, and load them up, and then I'd be able to ride them with their pretty decent speed. I mean, it's not crazy, but... I mean, they can hustle across the island pretty good. And I'll be able to just haul stone anywhere and everywhere I need it. And you can see I've already formed like a ninja parasaur train behind me. So both Mikey and Raph are loaded up. Raph's full of raw materials. Mikey is full of walls and foundations. Basically everything we need to build the barn. So I'm just going to build it. And I'm going to bring you guys along for the key steps in the build. Give me some time to clear this all out, and I'll come back with you when we're laying some foundations. All right, geeks? All right, guys, welcome back. We're going to start off with the foundation. I'm hoping that I don't have to resort to pillars and ceilings, but we'll see what we can do. My goal, I think, is a 3x4 building, 3 wide, 4 long, and with one of those sections being used as a sort of way to get parasaurs in and out of the build. So the actual barn space, or in and out of, to get them loaded up. So when it comes to the actual space inside the barn, I think it's going to be 3x3. So we'll keep laying these out. So there we go. And I think this is where Frances is going to rest most of the time. Now, she doesn't actually need a giant space, but I've planned out, I'll kind of figure it out as I go along, but I've got a dino gate in my inventory, and those... oh, I've got it in Mikey's inventory over here. And those are cool. I think that's what you want anytime you do. I think I might have two of them. No, I don't. I just have one. So we may have to build another one. Backing dinosaurs out of those, is kind of, especially when they're like this, isn't bad, but he's got a pretty good turning radius, so we could always bring him in And I think these are exactly too wide, or very close to it. Yeah, see how close that is? So, to center that, and to actually have walls on the whole thing, that means we need an even number width for a building. You know what? Let me continue laying some foundations, guys. I'm going to work out some of the design plans, and I'll come back to you. Alright, guys. Welcome back. I've ended up going, what, four by two with the foundations. And then I went and added the ceilings out here to widen it because I couldn't get another foundation over there. And then my original plan was to have a four wide building with a dino gate right in the middle. Well, I'm five long. Anyway, the plan was to have, four wide with the dino gate. And I think what I'm going to do is two wide with the dino gate, where I'm going to throw the dino gate down there. Before we do, let's get some ramps in. And I just want to test. What I'm thinking is this, that's not right. This area made from the foundations is four. Oh, that's going to suck if I can't put one there. Okay. One goes there. One. Yeah, is that really it? I think that's it. That's a bummer. Okay, let's see what this side looks like. Okay, good. Another one here. So what I'm thinking is Francis, the Ankylo, she'll come up here through a dino gate into a little barn. Off to the right side here are storage containers up against windowed walls, one in front of each. So that what I can do is, let's say I can get a ramp here, fingers crossed, I can. Yep, perfect. Say I can get a ramp there, then I'll hop on one of the paras or the whole train. Oh, you can't do it. So what I'm thinking is he's in the barn off to the right where that other ramp should be. And then I come up with the parasaurs. Whoops, there'll be a wall here, so it'll be a lot easier. We may have to widen this section, but I'm thinking this will be like a loading dock where I pull a parasaur up here. Then there's a windowed wall right here on my right. I think I may have to widen this whole section. We'll see. Yeah, we'll see about widening it. But then there's windowed walls here with storage just on the other side. So I'll pull in with Francis. Unload all the rock, all the flint, all the wood, whatever she's collected. And then I'll pull up with Leo, open the little window hatch, access the cupboard through the window, load them up, move the train along. Next thing you know, Mikey and Raph and a future Donnie will be up here, all getting loaded up. Now, I think what I'm going to have to do, my plan for the next segment here, I'm going to make a bunch more ceilings and a couple of pillars, and I'll widen this section over here. And then we'll start putting in dino gates and building an actual barn. I'm not sure when I'll come back, but I'll get some progress done, and I will be back with you guys when I've got it. Alright, so that's what I'm thinking, and now it's dino gate time. So we'll see if this locks in as is. If not, I may have to lay down a couple of those foundations. But the dino gateway, that's the key to some of the really cool builds in this. Yeah, it looks like it can just intersect with anything and everything. So the idea is just to make sure it's straight, and for that, I try and use the K camera. Now this keeps you from turning. It keeps you in a straight line so you can zoom out. You can walk forwards and left and right, but that's it. You can't rotate. And you want to make sure, it's so tough to do, you want to make sure that that is straight. So that the same amount of it overhangs the edge on both sides, and I don't think it is. So I'm going to try my damnedest straightening it. Oh, no, you're sticking out. Okay. And then we'll swing around and we'll see how it matches up with the walls we've put in. Alright, that looks fairly similar. I think that is almost centered. So what I'm just going to throw this in, and we'll deal with the consequences later. So my plan now that we have this in is to do windowed walls all along here, and then put storage chests like butted up against them so that from the outside you can access the storage, from the inside you can access the storage. To be honest, I haven't tested that, so I don't really know how it works. And then this, I think I'm going to not make it as tall, because I think the gate is three things tall, so I think I'm going to go two tall and then maybe try and taper it in. But I'll see what looks good once I've got once I got a handle on this. Let me throw up a bunch of walls. It will be the biggest transformation we've had in between cuts of me building yet. I'll put in a ton of walls and maybe even mess around with a roof. And I'll craft another dino gate, put it down this end, and I will come back with you guys. We have got another dino gate up. And I suppose, sorry, dino gateway. I suppose I should actually put the gates in. Yes. That looks good. Opens in. We'll do the same thing on the other side. I think I have one more of these gates ready. Come on, pull it out. There it is. Perfect. Beautiful. And so what I'm thinking is I'm going to have to roof this in. And like I said, I don't want to go to the maximum height of this. But I also, maybe I'm going to have to, because I don't want to mess up the workings of those gates. And the way I set them up, they open inward, which was my plan. But it's going to make a sloped roof a problem. So why don't we get a few more of these windowed walls in. I made just enough for this section. I think I can do it. Two rows, that's not right. We got a lot more materials waiting in the paras right now, so that looks right. Yes, don't mess with me. I got this on lock. Alright, one right here. Perfect. And I'm wondering how many of these... Yeah, let's go one here and one here. And other than that, I'm going to do regular old walls. That's my plan. And then I'll have to figure out a roof for this thing. Like I said, my plan was to have this portion over here where the parasaurs will be as sort of a lean-to. This isn't a permanent shelter for the paras. At some point, we'll build them a barn. But what I want is for whatever sort of pack animal I end up having, for them to have the ability to come through here, load up through these windows, and then have a safe spot in here for Frances. It's actually way bigger than she really needs. So I've kind of overdone it. I'm going to mess around with maybe putting an arched roof in. Or just putting a flat roof. I could also just do a flat roof across here and seeing if the doors can still open and close. Because maybe I can't place one. Here, let's do it right now. Let's do it on camera. I think I have some wooden ceilings stored in Mikey here. Do I have? I have stone as well. I do want a little diversity in this build, and we've only used wood so far, except for the pillars. So let's see what a stone ceiling would look like, and if it would let me place one here. No, it won't let me place one here. It'll let me place them starting back here, which would mean maybe I have to add another story just around the gates. Like, if I do it like this, does that get me to the top of the gate? That doesn't even get me to the top of the gate. Alright, so maybe I need to collect some more supplies, and we're going to have a much bigger build than I wanted because of these dino gates. I wonder, I probably should have just made them open outward, but I didn't want to mess up the ramp. I didn't want you to have trouble getting up that ramp. Oh, and I'm starving. No berries to eat either? Alright, well, we'll figure it out. I may have to keep messing around with this because if I can't do... Here, let's try this again. Will you let me? No, you won't let me go there. What if this is closed? No, I think the gate in general intersects with that. So whatever I try and build across there is going to be a problem. Unless I get higher. Unless we do this. And then I should be able to place one, right? Yes, I could. Okay, so maybe that's it. Maybe I do a full height ceiling here. I taper down one, taper down two, and then... No, that's a weird shaped building. Alright guys, I'm starving. I need to go get some food. I need to go get some more supplies if we're making this into a truly giant barn. You know, if it has to be this big, here's my thought. I need a safe place for my flyers, right? What if I do put a roof in somewhere at this height, right? And then we'll have two extra blocks of height above us. And I can even have the ceiling come to here, right? So that I could have Francis down on the bottom, and maybe I could have a safe spot for my flyers up on the top. That's an interesting thought, because right now I just have my new one, Squishy. Thank you, once again, to the donator of Squishy, up on that rock so she's in a safe spot. I'm going to keep messing around, guys. I know I'm dragging on a bit in this video, so I'll come back to you when I've made some serious progress on this build. I think I'm going to throw in these wooden railings here, guys. It's one of those finishing touches that I think is essential. I could have gone with the stone ones, and I also could have used these on the lower side where we have those foundations sticking out from below. But I like the way that looks. I was thinking I'd use those under here, but they don't line all the way up to the ramps. So I think I'm just going to do it like it is. I think I'm light enough now that he can carry me. Nope, not really. Let's see what I can drop. Half this stone, probably. And that ought to do the trick. Alright, can you go now? Can you go now? No, we'll drop more stone. That's alright, we're getting there. We're nearly done. Just drop all the stone. And then go. Yes, perfect. Let's put him up here. Alright, one there. And good. As you can see, I've now got those two little triangular pieces in place. This thing looking more complete than it ever has. And one more. Yes. Okay. It's very simple. I like it. And then the last step, let's land you, is to make a little loft for the flyers, like I was talking about. This building is way bigger than it needs to be for just one Ankylo. So what we're going to do is take a few of these, and I think just like that. That height. This is plenty of room for Francis. And if I can make a little landing in here, we'll see. We'll see how it looks once I got them in place. Then I'm guessing we can fly our flyers straight in, close the door behind us, and by not placing one in this last section, which we can't because of this door, we allow the doors to open. And if you are flyable, which I hope you are, yes, and at speed, I can come in and hopefully put this flyer straight onto this platform. Yes, and have a spot for it. And then when I want to go, open up. Oh yeah, that doesn't work so super well. The leaving doesn't work great. The leaving is horrible. But the entering would be wonderful. You just come right up to it, press Q or E for the average Joe, land, and you got a spot right here that's a lot safer. I have lost, like I said, two Pteranodons this week. Let's, by the way, try out our test run. I didn't build a storage. Let's build a quick storage container. Yeah, I lost two Pteranodons this week. One was Zero Blanco, and I took 03 out for some scouting, trying to figure out a good spot to do this building. And, what do I need? Just more wood. That's not bad. I got wood somewhere in one of these dinos. Mikey? Maybe it's in Mikey. If not, we're gathering some. Mikey, tell me you got some wood left. Maybe I've used all my damn wood. Okay, we'll chop down a real quick tree. Where's the nearest tree? Over here somewhere. Now, this is close enough where if I chop this down, it may never regrow. Because it might be within 75 meters real life distance of the building. And I think that's roughly how it works. Now look, you know what? That's not the best looking building I've built, but it's pretty solid. And maybe we'll get a coat of paint on that. We'll have it painted up. Yeah, let's crack open one quick storage container. The first one, yeah, I came home from scouting on 03 to find Zero Blanco and that Argentavis locked in a battle with some ants and Dilophosaurs, the Titanomyra and the Spitters. And I came back, I was able to call him back to safety, but not in time. He succumbed to his wounds. Things didn't go well for poor old Zero Blanco, who was my oldest and longest standing, probably my oldest tame at this point. Let's get you there. Okay, so that's in position. Obviously, we would have them lined along these walls, but I just want to make sure that if you're on the other side here, yes, perfect. That is the plan. So that, here, let's do it. Let's put it in action. Where is, before it gets dark, here, let me lighten things up a touch. That doesn't help all that much because we got fog rolling in as the sun sets, but we'll hop on her. We'll go break something real quick. Now, it's going to be far away most of the time. Oh, there goes the knight flying by us. Yeah, so that's what happened to Zero Blanco. 03... I was just scouting this island, Crags Island, and I spotted a dire bear, which is the newest creature in the game. So let's break a rock here. Alright, I don't want to break the whole thing, but... Oh, did I just pick a fight with that turtle? Get wrecked, you stupid Carbo. get destroyed. Okay, so let's say we've got a full load. Nowhere near a full load right now. Let's say we have that and we're riding back. Let me finish telling you about 03. I went in to check out this dire bear, which is this ancient flat-faced bear that I honestly thought would live almost entirely in the north west of the map, the frozen section, and they are spawning all over the damn place, and it was the first time I'd seen one, so... Oh, I'm in. Am I stuck? I might be stuck. Oh, that's a bad sign. Okay, well, let's hop off. So, you come in, you could take everything that's in there, which is this... this and this, right? I might have needed to make this a little wider. We'll see. Yeah, he's not loving the amount of space he's got in here. Okay, that's better. So then I'll hop in here, I'll throw in all the stone and stuff I have, and we'll take the parasaurs and we'll go check it out. Sorry, I know I'm back and forth between tutorialing this design, and God, it's pouring rain. Let's make it brighter. There we go. I know I'm jumping back and forth between telling a story and doing the tutorial here, but I'm going to hop on Raph and get Mike to follow me. Nope. Okay. But I can't help it. I'm not an amazing YouTuber yet. I'm still working on it. Get this. Okay, so Mikey is following Raph, and I'll hop onto Leo and make Raph follow Leo so that we get a little wagon train thing going. There we go. All right, so they should follow. Anyway, I got too close with 03 and the dire bear. I didn't realize, but they hit hard as hell, and he smacked 03 once or twice and killed him. Just flat dead. Now, 03 was never a high health dino. He was a speed and stamina flyer, but still disappointing. So it looks like I may need to make this roof a little higher. Otherwise, when I jump out of the saddle... Oh, no, I thought I was going to jump out of the saddle and end up on the roof, but I've literally ended up inside the dinosaur. Ha, okay. Well, there's some changes to be made. I think we got to raise that roof, but let's just say it's perfect. Let's just say it's perfect and that my head doesn't stick out. Then you got Mikey here, right? You can walk over to this container. You can take all from inventory. You can head over to Mikey's inventory, and you can fill him up. So... couple quick changes need to be made. I may need to adjust. Maybe I need to put the storage containers on the outside here. Maybe that's it, because this big beast is getting stuck inside. So maybe I'll take this storage container, I'll move it to the outside, and we'll have one in front of every window. And then, yeah, actually that's better, because I couldn't have one here because of the door. So we'll put the storage along the outside like this. And then we'll raise this roof one notch. But I'm going to do that in the future, guys. For now, I'm going to call this a finished build. This is my barn. It has room for my new flyer, Squishy, thanks to whichever tribe mate dropped her off. For Francis, who belongs to Garakus, if you ever come back to the server, she's all yours. I'm just looking after her for now. And we got a little loading bay for the Teenage Mutant Parasaurs. I love it. Geeks, that's going to do it for this episode in the middle of the night in the pouring rain. I'm Unite the Clans. Thank you so much for watching this one, and I will see you guys in the next episode. What is going on, guys? Unite the Clans here, back in yo lives with another episode of Life in the Woods Renaissance, and